Hello SOLIDWORKS power users, this is Alin Vargato from TriMech Solutions, and this very special tech tip. I invite you to see history being made. We will answer a very old question. Are there any limits to the offset entities command? Then you can see I already have a pretty complex spline drone. It is drawn on the top lane, as you can see, right? So let's create a sketch on the top lane. I'm going to select this spline and I'm going to try to offset it. How much should we go? Looks like 20 millimeter, there is no preview. What about 2 millimeter? 2 millimeter work? Yeah, looks like 2 millimeter works. Okay, what are the limits? So I'm going to turn on Instant 2D. That allows me to access this blue bubble to drag the dimension and see how the spline changes. And in this direction, looks like it stops less, around maybe 50 millimeter, a bit less, right? Let's go the other way. Drag, 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 and it stops now again, maybe less than 6 millimeters. So those are the limits of how much I can offset it. But I want to go past these limits. What I intend to do is to convert the spline into a series of linear segments, which I did already. I'll show you how later. So this is a completely different sketch that follows the spline contour. Let's try to offset this. So again, on the top plane, let's select one of these segments, go select chain, run the offset entities, and let's start again with 2 millimeter. You can see the 2 millimeter dimension here. I'm gonna try to drag this bubble and let's see if we can find limits. Look at that, I'm going way past what was possible before, and I can keep going. What about the other way? Let's go the other way around. And it's keep going. Even it's able to intelligently trim itself to find the solution. This is spectacular. I hope you guys agree. Being able to do this type of offset of, let's say, 25 millimeter, not 2 millimeter, but 25 millimeter, and still get something that's probably usable is spectacular. Now, how did I do this? And I'm using just technology that exists inside SOLIDWORKS, and probably anywhere from SOLIDWORKS 2020 to present, this is gonna work. Okay, let's start from scratch on the top plane. I'm gonna use the Q button to show the planes, start the sketch on the top plane, and start with a spline. Right, the shape is less relevant. What I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna convert it to a surface. I mean, I'm gonna use it for creating a surface, just using the extrude surface command. I'm doing that because I want to take advantage of new functionality in SOLIDWORKS. I'm gonna say new, let's say probably 5 or 6 year old, that allows me to convert a surface body or a solid body to a mesh body. Think about this as a way to approximate the bottom edge, which is our spline. And you can even specify how close you want to be to that ideal shape. Let's say 0.3 millimeter with a 25 degree deviation. Look at that, I'm doing it. Of course, you can try to use a different way to control this by defining the maximum element size, but in this case, I'm focusing on the bottom, so deviation pro is more important for me. Okay, and then let's go on the same plane and create another sketch on the top plane. I'm gonna run the intersection curve, not to this face, but to the whole body, the whole surface body. Click OK, and you can see the result. Linear segments. Let's get out of the sketch and delete this body. We don't need it anymore. Now let's name this new sketch converted to lines. And the original sketch, let's call it exactly that. Original sketch. How robust is this? Well, first of all, let's apply some colors. Let's make cyan the end result, and let's make maybe orange the original sketch. Right, so you can see how close they really are. What happens if I change the original sketch? Let me edit it and let's change its shape. Moreover, let's add an extra point somewhere here. Let's drag this one. As you can see, the new sketch updated pretty nicely. Now, what if I go even further than that and I add other segments, maybe a linear segment here, right? Maybe an arc. Maybe even further than that, let's go normal too. I want to create something that's not tangent. Goes like this, maybe. Would this work? Well, let's get out of here and see what happens. You can see how the new sketch updated as expected, right? So now it's just a matter of going again on the same plane, selecting these segments and running the offset command, and just have fun trying to find new limits to what before seemed impossible. So I can go this way, I can go this way, right? So you can see how nicely this works. I think this is the ultimate tech tip, just because it's such a fundamental question that we answered. Actually, two questions. First of all, how do you convert a spline into linear segments in a controlled manner? Second, how do we go past the offset limitations? And you might say, Alin, this is still not good enough. I would like the result to be turned actually back into a spline. Very good. We know how to do that, right? Simply run the, let's select again the resulted segments and run the fit spline command. You can even specify how close you want to be, let's say 0.1 millimeter. And the result, it's a spline. So if I were to extrude this as a surface, you're going to see it's going to be just one face. And it's an offset of the original. Hope you like this tech tip. And please let us know what you think. Do you agree with me that this is the ultimate tech tip of 2025?